So next is how to write down the chemical formula. The chemical formula of a compound is a symbolic representation of its composition. This is a definition of chemical formula. That what is chemical formula? It is a symbolic representation of its composition. For example, calcium oxide. It contains the two element calcium and oxygen, and its symbolic representation is CaO. The chemical formula of the different compound can be written easily. For this exercise, we need to learn the symbols and combining capacity of elements. So first of all, we have to learn these all symbols and their combining capacity, like sodium Na positive, silver Ag positive, sulfide S2 negative, sulfate SO4 2 negative, phosphate PO4 3 negative. So these symbols and combining capacity we have to learn. And what is the combining capacity? That is known as valency. The combining capacity, that is the combining power of the element, is known as its valency. The valency can be used to find out how the atoms of the element will combine with the atom of another element to form a chemical compound. Because when a chemical compound is formed, one element will combine with other element and share their valencies. The valency of the atom of the element can be thought of the hands or the arms of that atom. For example, human being have the two arm and octopus has the eight. This is a very simple example that human being has two arm, octopus has the eight arms. We will do crisscross, and by the crisscrossing we will get the answer H8O2. It means eight arms of this will go to H and two arms of the H will go to the O. We will get the answer H8O2. When we do whole number cancellation, that is cutting, we will get H4O. So this is H4O is the chemical compound formed between H and O. We represent the human being by H and octopus by the O. This is how we can get the answer OH4. Clear? So for all this we have to learn these valencies. That is, oxide have the valency 2, nitrate has the valency 1, ammonium has the valency 1, silver has the valency 1, zinc has the valency 2. So when we learn the valencies, then we will be able to form the chemical compound.